Gentlemen, good morning. Good morning. Okay, I come out with a topic called the effect of corruption in Tanzania, analysis of income inequality and economic growth. But corruption causes income inequality. It looks the gap between people who have and people who don't have is continuing increasing in your country. So I come out with this topic just to share with your themes and this culture week. Okay, there's few videos to show us how corruption is, that is anti-corruption manifesto, a video, and there is something in anti-corruption manifesto that does corruption affect women more unfavorably, that you re-answer yourself. And then do you think issuing pay for whatever, do you think first event being your company amount to the corruption? Corruption amount for more than 1 trillion in whatever, Saudi Arabia in whatever, is a whatever. But no one lost from big work in whatever. This video is very fast. And then we have another one, not this one, not this one. This one. We see a guy fighting for something. He's a boxer trying to do something. Punch for something. And as estimated in 2008, 92% increase over 65%. Punch, what is punching for? It exists in every office. Punching, that if you punch, it's fighting for corruption. It's fighting for corruption. Okay. According to Abubakar Jaibi Abukari, 15 October, born on the 15 October 1931 and died in 2015. It says that if a country is to be corruption free and okay, according to who a pastor can be, okay, I pronounce like Indian, Abu Bank Champi, 15 October 1931 to 27 June 15, he says that a country is to be
corrupted. Change the name.
Okay, if country is to be corruption free and become a nation of beautiful man, I strongly feel there are three key society members who can make a difference. They are father, mother, and teacher. Those are a big part which can teach as kids and his family on the way out to fight corruption and to remove. Jackson, a veteran US president, is successful explaining a wipe of the slavery of many countries when I see at this very day of its success experiment that corruption has been imputed to many members of the House of Representatives. And the right of the people have been a benefit of the promise of the prophet. Another one is an Indian again, Padma Devasin Patan. She said that corruption is the enemy of development and of good government. It must be got right of both government and the people at large. It must come together to achieve its national objective. Another one is Glorious Andreas Papadopoulos, that is a Greece Prime Minister in 2009-2011, has spoken about corruption also. It says, unfortunately, corruption is a widespread in government agencies and public enterprises. Our political system promotes nepotism and wasting money. This is undermining our legal system and confidence in the functioning of the state on the consequence that my citizens don't pay the tax. Another one is a musician, called Raymond Douglas, a British musician. The money and corruption are running the land, both the political betrayal, the workman pocketing the profit, and the treated on the ship. That's what, at least, it moved to. It causes us move to what is a definition of corruption, that is in two different categories, that is a petty corruption and grand corruption. Petty corruption, that is a small corruption, used by everyday corruption that happens between low-level government officials and the public. And conscious grand corruption occurs at the highest level of the government at the policy formulation. Now, coming to my topic that was very asked, Tanzania's state of corruption. There is 180 countries analyze and check the way out there. Address the issue of corruption and whatever. But your country in 2008 ranked 102nd out of 180 according to Corruption Perception Index. It is improved 1.9 to from in 1998 to 3.0 point in 2008. Other perception indicators such as World Bank, IFC, Enterprise indicate that 20% of business identified corruption was one of the largest constraints to business operation in the country in 2006 compared to 51% in 2003. This indicates strong decline However, the international community continue to see corruption whatever is a major problem. The Afrobarometer 2008 indicated that Tanzania society had been designated fighting corruption as fairly low priority with only 3%. The World Governance Indicator, which aggregates all individual indicators, use construct control of corruption, show that Tanzania's level of corruption has improved since 1998. In 2008, Tanzania had scored 47 as compared to 1998, where they had scored only 12. World Bank 2007, World Governance Indicator, also show positive trends in terms of control of corruption, which score 43 compared to 19 in 2003. Progress has also been recorded in terms of voice accountability, 43% compared to 39%, political stability, 39.9% compared to 29.8%, and whatever. According to the World Economic Forum competitive report, corruption is one of the major constraints of doing business in our country. The perception of seems decrease over time. 20% of companies surveyed with the framework of the World Bank and IFC 2006 Enterprise survey identified corruption as one of the largest constraints to the business operation in the country, compared to 51 in 2003. The 2004 Bank IFC Investment Climate Assessment undertaken in 2004 indicates large variation in perception of corruption across various regions. So the region identifying most prominent corruption is Tanga region is very corrupt. Iringa also is very corrupt. Is there anyone come from Iringa? Iringa, the famous town for house cars. Okay, if you want to meet a good house girl, you go from Iringa. Mbeya and Dar es Salaam and Arusha were identified as a region where the corruption is serious problem. Okay, what happened in 1996? Then our finance minister, Professor Mbilinyi, was resigned because of the certain issue on corruption. And 5 years later, Minister of Industry, it is simply resigned over the issue of the sugar import licensing. That is a photo for Professor Mbilinyi. I think you remember those days. And in December, by Saga, the lava scandal, no scandal in Tanzania has received much attention or as a bad rather case, both in Tanzania and in British, both Tanzania ought to receive £29.5 million, which is a British senior product officer at the decide by should be paid to Tanzania for the supply of air traffic control. I think you remember those days, and that is the amount, and you can think what happened in the economy when you don't start tax for budget to build roads and everything, economic activity. We lose a lot, £29.5 million. But when the government complain about the issue of radar, British pose conditions to return the money to our country. And they agree. They agree. But there was a very bad condition that the British must start the NGO to operate in our country and use our money. They say that they must control themselves our money. So it was very bad. In November 2010, the UK Department for International Development and Tanzania government drew up a plan on how to spend the money. They agreed that it should be invested in education, that is £4.4 for school textbook plus 192 desks, 1,106 teachers, house and 2,900 feet traffic. I don't think this man will dance anything on that agreement. Most of which I think is already eaten by the mafisadi. There's pepper scandal. Also used a lot of money. Teaching 1.33 billion external payment of EPA. That is 1.33 billion teachings on external account on EPA scandal. And the prosecutor of that. So the donor including African development funds, Canada, Denmark, EU, Finland, German, Ireland, Japan, Norway, Sweden, UK, and Oregon, together they push the government to do something on that an issue. And the most prominent figure on EPA scandal was the Dawood Hilary, but there was a complaint that Balali is not the one, but it was a force of the government because of the 2005 election. Most of the money from EPA account was used by the CCM during the campaign for the 2005 election. There was tax exemption scandal. I think you see those guys. Tax exemption scandal. You see Daniel Yona and the Mramba, Patrick Mramba, and the Ja. Now they caught. I think you see the law. They caught because of the tax exemption scandal. The former cabinet minister, Mr. Basri Mlamba, Daniel Yona, and the senior government official were charged in Kisutu the last month. And the issue was they accused giving potential treatment by granting full tax exemption to gold and silver fame. And you give a tax exemption to a gold and silver fame. That is not fair. From the United Kingdom. That is Alex Stewart Gold, Stewart government business corruption. That was Alex Stewart. Government business corruption offense they committed between August 2002 and June 2004. Mr. Alex Stewart, MS Alex Stewart, government business corporation, received $50 million in gold out fee from June 2003, where it was awarded a contract to August 2007. Richmond case. I think everyone is familiar about that famous figure, Edward Lowassa. A surprising decision. The only person arraigned over the Richmond power scandal, which led to resignation of the Prime Minister, has been acquitted of perjury. It was alleged that in June 2006, Mr. Nain Gire, a tender board, Gire, forged document that misleads the UNESCO tender board into believing that Richmond had the capability to produce 100 megawatts. That was a very big scandal on those days. Another one is Meremeta. Meremeta. Meremeta, that was a issue raised in the parliament, and Chadema show ministers for defense security, Joseph Salasim said, a select committee should be formed to find out the truth commenting the opposition camp has been trying to last 5 years to find about the ownership of Meremeta camp. The ownership of Meremeta gold mine was in bracket. No one knows who is that, but they discovered the opposition camp National Assembly also quarried on decision the parliament people, the Tanzania people defense force TPDF to sign contract with G2 Patel. So it was a contract between defense force TPDF to sign contract with G2 Patel. I don't know why TPDF signed the contract with G2 Patel, why there is a proper authorities to sign. And G2 Patel was the one also who put in a upper standard. That is the protocol G2 Patel. As for Sendor, the famous one, the government of Tanzania lose a lot of money from the escrow scandal that was account established in the central bank in 2007 for a dispute between Tanzania Electrical Company with Independent Power Tanzania IPTL, a joint venture between Malaysian firm Mekan Corporation and the local investor DIP engineer and the marketing company over the of a church capacity. Tanesco was ordered the policy of payment for IPTL pending. The agreement signed in 1985 involved 20 years power generation, needing to produce 100 megawatts, but the IPTL for years being functioning less than 10% capacity. So they signed an agreement was to produce 100 megawatts, but the IPTL produced less than the capacity and they paid. They paid and they produced 100 megawatts. That's the photo for IPTL. And this is a famous man, Lube Malila. But due to that issue of the escrow and economic perspective, Tanzania promised to receive 560 million US dollars in general budget support for 2013-14, for making it one of the largest CPMs in the world. But lack of accountability in the public, funds led to donor withdraw their support. Parliament passed resolution met President Despin, four officials in the scandal. Minister for Land and Tibetuka, Attorney General Frederick Warema, Energy Minister Sospita Mohongo, and Energy Parliament Secretary Eric Masi, there was that. Form of corruption in Tanzania. Bureaucratic corruption. According to the World Economic Forum, Global Competitive Report for 2014-2015, companies operating in Tanzania perceive inefficient government bureaucracy as a business constraint, facilitation of payments to speed up bureaucratic process are common practice. The World Bank 2015 Enterprise Survey indicates that 49.5% of the surveyed company report they expect to make informal payment to get things done. So they must make informal payment to make it done. If you want to start a company, you must do, you must provide something in order for things done. Then there's political corruption. Political corruption is a means for corrupt purpose, but knows Takrima. That is Takrima clues in the election, is the cheating. Sector most affected in corruption. Public procurement. Everywhere, public procurement. According to the World Bank and the FC 2006, enterprises survey 42% of the company expect to give cheating to secure a government contract. So many companies, they give cheating to secure the contract. If they don't give GFG, it means that they miss the very nice contract for procurement services. According to the Business and Corruption Portal, a procurement at the local level is reported to be more prone to corruption than the central level. Accounting to donor-funded projects is also reported to be very weak. Tender board must declare conflict of interest in tender because most of the tender boards, they are very corrupt. They are not trustful. Another one is corruption in tax administration. Complex law, lack of administrative capacity, create an environment conducive to corrupt practices, leading to low level of trust toward the tax collector, for instance, of TRI staff, solicited bribe during tax assessment have been reported. In 2006, a parliamentary survey indicated 55% of respondents believe that some and most of all tax officials are corrupt. Most of the tax officials are corrupt. Most officers in TRA are corrupt. 15% company surveyed with the framework of 2016 World Bank FC Enterprise survey report that expecting to give gift to make information payment in meeting of the tax official. Corruption in the police. Don't tell them that I mentioned them here. I remember that journalist what Muro when he mentioned police that corrupt. He was dead and he was charged. The police in general and the traffic police in particular are considered extremely vulnerable to corruption. As salaries are very low and junior staff members are reported to engage in pet forms of corruption. Senior officers, meanwhile, are reported benefit with the percentage of overall bribe. According to 2006 Commonwealth Human Rights Report, the Prevention of Corruption Bureau report in 2003, that the police department was the most corrupted institution in Tanzania. Police department was and is most corrupted department in Tanzania. In survey conducted in 2002, more than 60% of respondents knew someone who had experienced corruption involving traffic police. 60% of respondents knew someone who had experienced corruption involving traffic police. 18% meanwhile had been directly exposed to traffic police corruption. And then there is judicial corruption. Freedom of House report from 2006, it is low standard judicial service due to the poor regulatory framework, weak management and condition of the judicial institution, and ineffective of human resource administration. Also, there is judicial corruption. There is corruption in natural resource management, according to 2014 article from Danish organization cited by the Business and Corruption Portal. Most of the revenues generated by law. Did you notice something on my citations? Most of the citations from outside the country. Do you guess why? Why not citations come from our countries? That is the question you have to ask. According to 2014 article from Danish organization cited by the Business and Corruption Portal, most of the revenue generated by logging are loss of the corruption. The study estimates that 5% of the revenue from the timber go to the village and the local authorities, while 95% end up with the pockets of corrupt politicians. So, causes of corruption, incompetence, and inefficiency in delivery of the public service, legal and administrative or political framework that provide an atmosphere conducive to existence of corruption, lengthy difficult procedure on security of employment, lack of transparency, lack of political will, erosion of integrity leadership, and emergence of conspicuous concerns of corruption. Impact of corruption that is a failure to achieve the government objective, rise of administration costs, diminution of revenue collection, diminution of aspect of authority, rose productivity, reduced foreign investment, corruption as representative of institutionalized unfairness, and veritable leading to litigation and the culmination charges, with even the honest official may be a bad name and lack of justice situation met. Okay, that is something about economic growth. Is there economic growth? Corruption may result to excessive government regulations and intervention which induce firms or individuals to bribe public officials to get in such a setting. Corruption may have positive effects on economic growth. In such a setting, corruption may have positive effects on economic growth, as it forces firms and individuals to engage in economically beneficial activities, dispute high level of bureaucracy, all their bars and the law. The cause of mechanism, transmission channel in corruption and growth relationship. The channel for corruption. One channel through the corruption may affect economic growth in private investment and foreign. The invest-induced effect of corruption growth may occur as a result of increasing cost of investment because of the corruption. You are supposed to pay some so that the cost of investment increases. Because the cost increases, it means that automatically, because most of the things they operate in order to get the economic profit. So if they knew exactly that they would never get economic profit, they withdraw the investment to our country. Quick investment penalty. And then increase direct cost of production. That is very dangerous. And high uncertainty for future return of investment in capital. So you invest, you expect the return in capital, and most of the company, they try to focus. Because they using 10 series data and whatever, you can focus for 5 years, 10 years, whatever. So that if the focus is negative, so that's why most of the companies they withdraw to invest in our country. Corruption may also affect growth through public investment expenditure, even in public expenditure. The effect here may be due to adverse selection of the public investment project. That is a big issue, all bias of allocation. Because in the case of adverse selection, project with high political returns may be selected. Project with high political returns will be selected. If it's not any benefit, don't have any benefit with the CCM, it's very difficult to be selected. In case of biased resource allocation, corruption may lead to unsustainability. With high level of the public investment, the finance at the high cost of the public borrowing, with the consequence of the increased mortality and the low growth rate in the enrollment. Corruption also affects economic growth through adverse effect on quality of the government. Government institution in general. Corruption is a symptom of institution deficient, but it may also exacerbate such deficiencies by rewarding deviation or defections from optimum normal enforcement mechanism. The extent that in the case of corruption effect, the optimizing decision of economic actors through the distortion is the cause in the cost of the incentive structure, but the effect. Corruption distorts the risk associated with investment decision, the cost of the transaction, the level of trust, and the capacity of the polite to resolve distribution of the goods of the company. So, the big issue caused by corruption is the devaluation of local currency. Now we are facing a very bad situation in our country on devaluation. According to Benundu, it's safe because the journalist asked him why there is continued devaluation of our local currency in these days, and it's safe that the fall of shillings has been attributed to the severe shortage of foreign currencies in the market and strong demand of the currencies by the importer. The shillings has experienced sharp decline, whatever. And because of the escrow scandal, the government lose $5.58 million in the financial year 2014-2015. So because we lose a lot of foreign currency, just imagine we miss $5.58 million in the BOT, because most of the donors, they refuse to give us $5.58 million in the financial year 2014-2015. It means that a BOT, in microeconomic perspective, don't have enough funds for purchasing or for importing commodities from outside. That is a very bad issue if a bank lose external currency, especially US dollars. And also in our bank, we don't have gold reserve. That is a very big problem. The economist honest in Bali, and the lecturer from Zumbe University, he said governments is like to face further budget deficit and be unable to implement many development projects that really have a foreign donor. Dr. Ngoi said delay in funding could lead to inflation and the effect of the country plan float of $700 million in 2015. That is a prominent figure, that is Dr. Ngoi. Corruption inequality, there is big inequality increase because few people, they get a lot, Dual mechanism influence corruption, increase inequality. So as corruption increase, also the income gap between Tanzania increase. The second mechanism is the poor effective target of social program to the tools need due to corruption, that is siphoning funds for poverty alleviation. So most of the funds for poverty alleviation is taken by the few. Okay, you can see a corrupt house, and some people, a facade house, and somebody in the village house. That's the, it just made the income gap, very big income gap between the poor and the rich. The third mechanism identified for inequality is the one link of the formation of human capital. Education, as it has been already pointed, pointed out, corruption decreases public revenue. And so effective public expenditures include education expenditure and are scaled down. For education expenditure also are scaled down. Corruption has detrimental effect of the structure of the public expenditure in such a way that share education is substantial decrease. Rural provision of public education has a detrimental effect on the ability of the poor to invest in the human capital. So, lowering provision of education. If you remember that education is a very great investment, and most of us, we don't think that education is an investment, because just imagine, since you were born, you are in school, and each year you pay school fee. Just imagine how much you pay until now. That is an investment. So expectation is that after complete education, you must give return to such investment. And that investment we call human capital investment. So most of the Tanzania, we don't perceive that education is an investment. We call that it's a function. For most of us, we come as a function, and when you employ it, you go there without any skill, you go there with some skill, and they will call you some skill labor. You stay in a company without any difference for 5-10 years, you don't produce anything, and you expect that the country will develop. So, until when we change that perception is when we continue to develop. Lowering provision of public education as a detrimental effect on ability of the poor to invest in the human capital, and that influences low returns to the human capital of the poor comparing with the rich. So because of the corruption, also education system is corrupt also, and most of the problem, or the big problem, is that investment in human capital, it will be very bad, because most of rich people, their children, they will study in a better school compared to the poor. So this is my conclusion of my presentation.